Hello everybody and welcome back to the channel. In today's video we are gonna watch some Chingiz Allazov highlights. The reason that we're gonna watch his highlights is because he is fighting Marat Grigorian this weekend in ONE Championship. As most kickboxing fans know, ONE Championship has currently the most stacked 70 kilograms division, and for them they call it the featherweight division. In other organizations they call it the lightweight division. And as you could see in the title, we're gonna talk about Chingiz Allazov a little bit more. People see him as the pound for pound number one fighter. Websites like Beyond Kickboxing, Combat Press all rank him as the number one pound for pound. And at this moment currently, I would say the exact same thing. I do have to say that I haven't watched too much of Chingiz Allazov, but after his last fight that I did see, I can definitely tell he's pound for pound number one fighter in the world. But this weekend he will have a tough test in Marat Grigorian, who is currently ranked also in the top 10 of pound for pound fighters, and that will be very interesting to see this weekend. Okay, so here we have his fight against Superbon, which was his last fight, which gave him the title. It ended, I think, in round one, and it was a really great performance. Like I said, I haven't seen that much of Chingiz Allazov, so yeah, let's watch it together. He's a very technical fighter and has a bit of a Thai style with pretty good boxing, with pressuring boxing. So I think he has a little advantage over Superbon because he's a little bit more dimensional fighter. And look at the beautiful combination. Has some very good hooks. And Chingiz also, what you can see is he has a very good, he definitely shows the differences good between high and low. He works a lot to the body, to the head, he makes great combinations. Yeah. And he's very good at changing the tempo. He can make, he knows when to be fast and when to punch hard, which you can really see in his game. And his counters are very good. Here he gets a warning because in kickboxing rules you cannot hold the leg, but most people know. But still, some kickboxing organizations still allow that. Look at the counters. When he gets a kick, he immediately counters with a punch and a kick. Let me put the sound a little bit lower. And he perfectly works the body also in his combinations. And he also makes a ton of low kicks, which also is visibly... okay, skip this. Look, another low kick. He immediately finishes and counters with a low kick. Especially against a kicker against like Superbon.
Combination there, and then we stepped in. The kick, it was actually in some south stances and threw that
10 seconds, round one. And this is a 5-round fight, so you can see that he is not putting that much pace on, but he makes his points by countering every single moment. Just look at this, he immediately counters with a punch and a kick. That's how you perfectly have to fight against a Thai fighter, because Thai fighters' kicks are the best in the world, let's be honest. Especially the middle kicks and high kicks. But yeah. Let's skip this to the start of the next round. Look at this, here he's gonna put more pressure on. But he keeps holding the leg, and that's where he probably will almost get a minus point for. Ooh, perfect Superman punch, and you can see Superbon is hurt. Oh, and there it is. And this is not smart from Superbon by standing up immediately. I've also had one or two 8 counts, and I can tell you that you first have to stay down for 5 seconds, because then you'll get hurt too fast. And now, you know, you need to take your rest, because when you stand up, you have a big possibility of falling down. Here he already has 2 8-counts, and Allazov really wants to finish the fight. And here he goes full pace, and here it's ending. 3 8-counts, and as you can see, Superbon is knocked out, and Allazov wins the belt. I don't remember if this was also... I don't remember if this also was in the tournament, but he definitely won the one championship belt. I think their one championship has 2 belts. One that's, well, 2 gold definitely, but like, I am not sure if it was the tournament, but I think Chingiz already won the tournament also before facing Superbon. Anyway, this was Chingiz Allazov last fight. I think this is a highlight video of Chingiz Allazov that we are gonna watch. It's 9 minutes long, but I'll cut off to the good parts of the video. Because I remember he's also a K-1 champion, and he has a belt in basically all the big promotions. I don't think he has a glory... No, he does not have a glory title. But if he would win that, then he would have a belt in every single organization. I think this is going from the beginning of his career to later, so let's put it a little bit further. Here, to his K-1 days. Because here he won the K-1 tournament, and it's great to that we have some highlights of it. Let me put it the noise a little bit... Let me put the noise a little bit down. Here we go. One sec, let me put a little bit lower. Oh, look at those beautiful hooks. That's really one of his greatest weapons. And he works the body. Good boxing. Knows when to place his high kicks. Oh, and a beautiful knee. He's such an all-round fighter. Ooh, and another high kick. Like, how is his opponent still standing? Here we go. This was the first fight of the tournament. This was an 8-man tournament. I think around 2017 or 2018. And I think here he's facing Jordan Piqueur, who is also... he just fought for the K-1 belt like 2 weeks ago, I think. Oh, but here he has a very heavy knockout. You know, as you can see, again with a hook, he really also switches a lot. He has a good left hook, he has a good right hook, which makes him really ordinary. Look at that, perfectly timed. I mean, it's sad to see him against Piqueur, but... Oh, and here he's fighting Kido, who's also like one of the bigger stars of the K-1. And here he gets gives him an 8-count in the first round. Oh, perfectly placed. And against the great combinations, switch up, and the high kicks from Look at how close of a range. Look, from he's almost standing against him and he still hits him. Here he goes down again. Look at that, perfectly timed push kick. And the high kicks, he's so fast. And here he gets another 8 count. I don't know, I think it was the finish. Oh wait, sorry, he has one more fight. But I think this was already when he became a K-1 champion. But yeah, I can go on all day with this. But yeah, this was also like one of his career highlights, so... Now we should watch a little bit of Marat Grigorian. Okay, here we have one fight of... I think this was also the last fight of Marat Grigorian against Typhoon Özkan. But in this fight, I think Typhoon had the little advantage over him and should have won. But it was a very close fight, you know. I don't think you can always talk about that it was a robbery if it was a very close fight. But in my opinion, I think Typhoon won this fight. What doesn't take anything away from Marat Grigorian, because I'm also a big fan of him. I really love his kickboxing style, forerunning pressure and lots of low kicks. But yeah, I'm not gonna watch this fight right now because this fight is more, or this video is focused on Allazov. So let's get one time again to here, Marat Grigorian. We'll watch some highlights of him. Does this also start with old fights first? Yeah. Yeah, he was a glory champion. He also, I think, is this Kunlun? Or is this Wuling? I think this was Kunlun. And if I'm right, he also became a champion from here. But from here, I think we can watch because this is not too long ago. Just look at how much combinations he makes. Wow, and this is against Sitichai, I think? I'm not exactly sure. I think it was against Sitichai, who's also a great fighter. Also, one of the best fighters in the division. Oh, look at that. And here we go, he's fighting Sitichai here again. And I think this was also for the title. Very forewarning pressure, lots of low kicks. Yeah, this was for the belt, and I think he also won it here. Here, a victory over Christian Baia. I think the Sitichev fight was a little bit later than this fight. Oh, here we have it again. Oh, I think he lost the first fight against Sitichev, but I'm not exactly sure. But he definitely won this one, I think, because he won the belt, defended it once or twice, and then he went to one championship. He's also fought against Tijani Bestati, who was still young at the time. Here we go, here we have the fight. Here was Grigorian, already a champion. Already lots of low kicks, forwarding pressure. And he has a great conditioning. Even though Tijani has grown so much since this fight also. I think Tijani doesn't have as much competition in glory, but I still think he needs all the credits he deserves. Because of course all the fighters are at one championship right now, but they are not fighting. And Tijani, who's also fighting at glory 87, not Collision. He's gonna fight against Kaito, a Japanese fighter, but that video will be online very soon. I'm gonna make predictions on that. But yeah, let's watch a few more fights. Maybe are there... Here we also have some one championship fights from Marat. Look at the combinations, forwarding pressure, good guard, and lots of low kicks. And also very good punches to the lever, as you can see, liver. Against Andy Sauer, who was all out of his prime. I don't really like to see that. Especially out of his prime, you know. if they both will be in their prime, it would be a great fight. But alright, and that was it for this video. Do you think Marat Grigorian will shock the world and beat Allazov? Or do you think Allazov will remain pound for pound the number one fighter in the world? Let me know in the comments. And with this, I would like to thank everybody for all the support I've been receiving. And please subscribe if you haven't. And I hope to see you in the next video. Bye.